I remember the first time I came across the word branding was when I attended the Launch X Entrepreneurship Summer Camp at Northwestern University. And after that camp, I fell in love with the idea of branding. Before that, I might have come across the word branding, but really didn't know what it meant. Now, as an entrepreneur, I'll pose the question to you. What does branding mean to you? See, for most people, the moment they hear branding, what comes into their mind is a logo. As a brander, most of the time a client would come to me and ask me to create a logo for them. But the question is it a logo or a brand that they really want? Now, you might be wondering, what's the difference between a logo and a brand? And I'm going to tell it to you. See, a logo is a visual representation that aids in public identification and recognition. On the other hand, a brand is not a logo, an identity, or a product, but rather, a brand is a person's gut feeling about your product or service. Human beings are emotional and intuitive when it comes to selecting brands. So what branding does then is influencing the gut feeling that people have about your product or services. So branding helps you understand your business culture, attributes, messaging, mission and vision, among others, in order to help you establish a strong brand position. So if branding influences gut feelings about your products or services, what power does it have then? See, when you think about it, people don't buy products or services, but rather they buy experiences and they buy better versions of themselves. They don't care about the time, effort, or investment you made into creating your offering, but rather they care about how your offering is going to change their lives and how it's going to make their lives better. Through proper emotional branding, you'll not only differentiate yourself from competitors, but you'll also be able to create products and services that are human-centered. You'll also be able to create messaging that speaks about your brand and messaging that customers can interact and feel part of. Next time you decide to create or change the name of your startup, visual identities, attributes, mission, vision, and culture, among others, remember to put your customers' emotion at the center of your branding. This is because branding breathes life into your products or services, and it creates messaging and experiences that your customers would want to be associated with. Now, more than ever, people make choices of brands based on the values and what they want to stand for. And be sure to have a proper, creative, and effective branding if you want them to choose your brand. And one more thing, as an entrepreneur creating the next big thing, when you create services and products that offer your customers with the best experience available, do not forget to tell them how lucky they are to interact with your brand. And do this through branding.